Hi Earth Signs, Tarot Twins here. Welcome to my channel. I am joined by Black Feather Tarot.
Hi Earth Energies.
This is for Taurus, Capricorn, Virgo, and we're going to be spying on two people, your current lover, your current person, and your ex. So, excuse me, we'll see what comes up in the cards for you, Earth Energy. If you would like a private reading with the Tarot Twins, please feel free to be in touch with Tarot Twins as your subject line. We've got a few more availabilities, so feel free to email me ASAP if you wanted to and organize a private reading with the both of us. Feel free to head over to Black Feather Tarot YouTube page, okay? Lots of love content over there. I'll link the page in the description box. Otherwise, we'll start off with you and we'll see what comes up.
Definitely. Okay, we'll give the cards a shuffle and we'll now be spying on your romantic energy here. Okay, your current romantic energy and see what's going on with him or her. Okay, they do have the Seven of Pentacles, the Four of Wands, Two of Wands, the Knight of Wands. They've got the World and lastly the Star card. Okay, the Seven of Pentacles. Your current romantic energy, it feels like it's more maybe of a slower moving energy, or something feels like it's stagnated a little bit. Maybe they feel as though it could be your energy though, because you know you are coming up as a earth energy here, Taurus, Virgo, Capricorn. Something here is not moving as quick as you want it to be. Okay, so something here might have come to a standstill, a stalemate, or a stagnation. Someone here feels like they're putting in so much effort, but sadly they're not getting the results, okay, that they want. It's like, you know, they're investing so much of themselves into this connection, but they're not generating those positive results here. So someone feels a little bit let down, or someone feels a little bit frustrated with the pace in which things are traveling along. The Four of Wands, I'm seeing some sort of celebration or reunion around you and your current romantic energy, though it could be them. There is someone here that I feel like they're embracing. It could be a long lost friend or a relative, or it could very well be that this is a past connection, okay? And you've had something, you've started something with this person way back, and now they're coming back, okay, and they're hoping for a reunion or a reconciliation with you. This is also someone who I feel like, if the two of you have known each other for quite some time, irrespective of the you know, time frame, I do feel like this your person here feels as though what the two of you have, and maybe that's why they're taking that time, because they feel like they have long-term visions and long-term plans for you. They actually see you as the one they could possibly settle down with and end up with, get married to, or ride off into the sunset Disney style here. Two of Wands here, we do have a lot of planning around your person. So I feel like, again, they're looking forward to something very much so. Reunion, anyone? Reconciliation, coming back together, or perhaps moving in together. It's like they're anticipating, they're waiting, they're counting something down. So a very strong notion of waiting for something or waiting for someone. They could very well, of course, be waiting for you to reach out. Have they left you with some sort of question in which they need an answer? I feel like they're waiting for something, okay? Or maybe you're the one that's waiting on them here, but I get a sense that something is not moving as fast as it should be, or at the very least that's how someone feels. But remember guys, a slow moving connection is going to outlast fireworks any day, right? The Knight of Wands, I feel like something is going to shift, because I feel like there's a change in pace. Your romantic energy is moving towards you. Something shifts and I feel like they start chasing you, okay? I'm not sure if you've pulled away, if you've distanced yourself away. They notice this and they're going to come in. I mean, they're charging in headstrong here, okay? Strong attraction, strong fire, primal energy here. So there is a very strong levels of attraction, lust and infatuation. And I feel like your person wants to build on that slowly, but they do want to build on that. The World card here, I do feel like there is a possibility for the two of you to actually do this long term, okay? This is something that can go the distance. And I feel like your person here is definitely wanting, you know, they're wanting a future with you, or they're wanting to develop plans for the future. For some of you, you are doing a long distance relationship. This person is thinking about you and they're thinking about how you can make this work for their future here. I'm seeing that there's also a lot of transformation or healing energies around your person, okay? I'm also seeing that your person, though they are a little bit quiet or slow moving or reserved, this is someone who is going to want to be like very open and transparent with you. Notice the nakedness in the World card as well as the Star card. This is something you're laying the foundation for, a very honest, transparent and open relationship, okay? And that is a very strong foundational structure right there, guys. So that's what we have for your current romantic energy. And now we are going to move along over to your ex's energy and see what's going on with them. I mean, are they still thinking about you? Have they moved on? What are they up to? Let's spy on them.
Okay. Taurus, Capricorn, Virgo.
Ooh.
Okay, Knight of Wands has also come up here. And the Star card.
This is interesting.
Oh, wow.
I did mention that this could be a past energy, didn't I,
guys? Yeah, you said reunion.
I did say reunion or reconciliation or rebuilding or something.
It could be with an Aquarius or a fire sign, Aries, Sag, Leo here. Okay.
So your ex may also be your next again.
Okay, yeah, wow, super powerful. Look, I think for the most part, yeah, there is a reconciliation on the cards because there's a lot of communication coming in with the Eight of Wands. This is about growing and moving past the past trials, past tribulations, past problems that you experienced in a connection. What I'm seeing here, though, for some of you, your ex is doing the online dating thing, but they're treading very lightly. They're possibly engaging in some sort of negative behavior, okay? Seven of Swords can be like deceit, walking on eggshells, tippy-toeing, okay? So your ex might be playing someone, all right? They might be playing someone new that they're seeing, and some of you are sort of like watching this going, all right, well, I'm glad you moved away because this person could be doing something not really good in a relationship, okay? Because we have the Deception card. Of course, this is not going to be for everyone, but for some of you watching, if this person was notorious for doing these sorts of things, being hurtful, keeping things from you, being secretive, chances are they're still doing that, but they're just doing it to someone else. For others, I feel like this ex is in a period of healing, okay? They might be doing the online dating thing. They might be chasing fame. They're in the public eye for some reason, or they're trying to get themselves out there. Something about exposure. Yeah, ex could be doing some traveling as well here with the King of Wands. Some physical activity is what I'm getting here as well. There may be an emotional bond that's being formed, possibly with a water sign, Cancer, Pisces, Scorpio, because the Queen of Cups, looks to this chalice here, this holy grail, and it's so precious and so meaningful, and she's just so in awe. She's holding it so gently. So I get the sense that for some of you, this ex does have a love connection, okay, that is around them. But I feel like they might still be in the talking stage, the courtship phase, but there's an emotional bond that's being formed with this person. And it may be someone they've met online or someone that does live further away. The Knight of Wands is known to be quite a figure of travel. So this person might be communicating with someone overseas, maybe a different city, state or country. But again, there's been some turbulence here for them with the ex. For some, I feel like your ex has had trouble getting a new connection. So it's like it's not working for them somehow. Like they are feeling some sort of emotional link towards someone, but it just doesn't seem to be working as yet. You know, the king is all dressed up. We've got the knight. He's in armor. So there's a sense of this ex of yours still appearing defensive, okay, towards a new love connection in some capacity. So it's like they have their guard up. They're keeping people at a distance. But the Star card can speak about destiny, and it can speak about fate. It can speak about things being possible once again. And I do feel, going back to that, that it's very, very, very likely that there's this ex that feels like you were their destiny and you are their destiny, Earth signs. Okay, you've come up as, they feel you are written in the stars for them. You were made for them. So
shining light in their darkness.
Yeah, that's exactly it. And I really feel that's being reinforced here in the cards. So I feel like for a lot of you watching, there appears to be some sort of link with, it's either the same person or it's this ex that's somehow picking up your energy and somehow maybe wants to reach out, wants to reconcile, wants to heal things. And they're coming up in both these energies, and that's really powerful. We don't see that too often.
No, it hasn't happened, has it? It hasn't happened with the other readings. So that is very interesting that it's come up quite closely connected here, interconnected rather. So exactly, your ex may just very well be channeling your energy. I mean, which could also be strong indications of a twin flame connection. Mm. Or it could be that, you know, this, your current romantic prospect is the ex, is the one we're talking about here.
Yeah, really interesting.
Yeah, very powerful stuff. Okay, guys, and that pretty much sums up your reading. So thank you, as always, for watching and listening. Please show your support by subscribing, commenting, or sharing.
And also emailing if you wanted a private reading.
Yes, with the subject line Tarot Twins. We do have a few slots still available. Otherwise, guys, we will be sharing with you more Tarot love messages, so do stay tuned.
Thank you again.
Thank you, and
bye for now.
Bye.